This is for the midpoint and distance class activity. So what you're going to do is you're going to open up your Desmo account. Make sure you sign in so that way you can save it and then share the link with me. What you're going to do is you're going to continue to do what we did before, but I'm also going to introduce to you, there's a little plus sign up here. When you want to make notes, you're going to use this right here, or to shortcut, you can actually just do the quotation mark on your keyboard. It'll automatically know, because when you do quotation mark on the keyboard, you'll see the quotation mark right here. This will not affect any formulas or anything like that. If you don't put the quotation marks, it's going to say, like if you take a note, say something like note or something like this, this is going to show up, and then it's going to cause some problems because it doesn't know what to do with it. So make sure you all make sure you put a note by doing the quotation mark, or put it on the keyboard and use quotation mark. Also, the tables right here, you're welcome to use the table right here, or what we did last time was we typed in the word table. The table should appear right here. Okay, so there's a couple ways to do those things. All right. So what you're going to do is you're going to go ahead, and I'm going to make a quotation mark because this is going to be for problem letter A, and the points are 6, 0, and 10, 6. So I'm going to write it out like that so that way I know what problem it is. So from here, I'm going to go ahead and insert the table in here, and we're going to create the table doing the 6, 0, and also 10, 6, just like we did last time. And so that's going to give us these two points right here. So if I want to zoom in, we can zoom in here. And then from here, we want to go back to these little dots right here at the Y1 and kind of press it for a couple of seconds. And that's going to give us this table right here. So when it drops down to that, the lines, we want to turn on the line. And then you can choose whatever color you want for the line right there. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and use the purple color. Now from here, for the next point, I want you guys to do is find the midpoint. So I'm going to put the little quotation mark because this is just formula. This is basically showing the work. I guess the easiest way I can think of is doing X midpoint. And then we're going to go ahead and put a colon. And then go ahead and do the formula. So if you remember, the midpoint is taking the X numbers right here. We're adding those two up right there and divided by 2. So that's what we're going to do right here. We're going to take our 6, add it up to the 10, divided by 2. And that's going to equal to 6 plus 10 is 16. 16 divided by 2 is 8. So now I'm going to do the same thing for the Y. So quotation mark, Y midpoint. And then we're going to put colon. So now we have is now the Y number. So we're going to add these numbers right here and then divided by 2. So it's going to be 0 plus 6 divided by 2 equals, so 6 plus 0 is 6. 6 divided by 2 is 3. So now from here, I guess the next part is you can write the coordinates, but then you can also put it back up here. So I'm just going to put it back up here so you actually see the drawing. And this is a great way to check your work, because if it's correct, then it's going to be in this point right here. And that looks good because that looks like the midpoint of the two points right here of the line right there. Okay, so that looks good. So now I also want you to find distance. So distance, we're going to go ahead and put distance. Oops, I didn't put the little quotation mark. So quotation mark distance. And we're going to say distance is, now you're going to have to do the square root. And we can actually allow the calculator to do the work, but I'm just going to do basically the skeleton of this. So the nice thing of the distance is once I actually have this work right here, it's basically this right here, but instead of the plus sign, it's going to be subtraction and then also squared. So I'm going to take my 6 minus the 10 and we're going to square it. Now squared, because it's not formula, since it's under the note, we're going to use this thing called a caret. So the little upside down V is going to be a caret. So that's your squared right there. Plus, because that's formula right there. And then we're going to do the same thing right here. We're going to take our 0 minus the 6 And we're going to say squared again. So upside down caret and squared. Okay. So now that is just a formula to help me remind me, because now I'm actually going to go ahead and calculate it. So with this, the keyboard right here, there's a little square root button right here. So we're going to go square root, and we could copy, maybe copy and paste all of this. Can I copy and paste it? Let me see. So if I take all of this and I put it in here, copy and paste, perfect. It does copy and paste. So it actually calculates for me, because this right here on the side, the calculator is doing the work right here, said it is equal to 7.211. So that's going to give us the distance or the length of this line right here. Okay, so that's this part right here. So then you're going to do the same thing, and we'll just add on to it. So you can say B, oops, we got to do our quotation marks again. So B, and then you can put the coordinates. So that way you also know what the next part is. So 2, 9 and 7, 5. And we'll do the same thing. So the next part, create your table and then put in 2, 9. And then the next one will be 7, 5. So 7, 5. That's going to give us something in there. Like, I only see one dot right here. So where's the other one? So, there we are. So it's over here. So again, we want to draw the line. And you could probably, when you draw the line, you'll see it better too. So we're going to turn on the line. There it goes. So then we have is the line right there. Okay. Now you're going to go back and find the midpoint as well. So let's continue on. So we have is midpoint. So I'm going to go, note X midpoint. And the midpoints are the two numbers where we add 2, 7, and divided by 2 equals. So 7 plus 2 is 9. 9 divided by 2 is about 4.5. Okay, the next line, we're going to go ahead and do quotation. We'll do the Y midpoint. Midpoint. So then we have the two numbers that we're going to add up right here, the 9 and 5. So we have is 9 plus the 5 divided by 2 equals. So 9 plus 5 is 14. 14 divided by 2 is 7. So now those are my points right there. And I just need to put it into my table, the 4.5 and 7. And that should look like the midpoint. Yep, that looks like the midpoint right there. That looks good. Okay. So again, you'll know, because if you accidentally, for example, put in 7 and 4.5, look at the dots over here. And it's thinking that it needs to connect the dots, so it's going to create something funny like that. So that's when you know you have it the wrong point. You need to go back and check it, because obviously it has to be somewhere around here, the point right there. Okay? So I'm going to fix that up right there. So 4.5 and 7. Okay. Oh, this is getting in the way. So this one right here, the keyboard, I can hide it by pressing this little arrow key right there, and I'll bring it down. All right, so now from here, let's go ahead and find distance. So distance is, and then we do the same thing. So we just look at the midpoint right there. Those are good. That makes it easy for us too. So 2 minus 7, and then squared. Then we have this plus 9 minus 5 squared. Okay, so now from here, I can just now turn on the calculator and do all the work right there. So square root, go back here, and we're just going to copy and paste it. So we're going to go here, I highlight it, and the keyboard is Control C. Then when I come back here, I'm going to Control V. That's going to give us the paste right there. So now that is going to be now the distance or the length of this line right here. Okay, so then you'll just continue and do the same thing. So the next one you'll do letter C, and then you'll continue and just continue to do all the work. So once you're done with all the work, don't forget to go back up here and make sure you save it. So once you save it, make sure you get the link right here, copy the link, and then go back and embed it into the assignment and make sure you submit it. Okay, so this is the activity for the midpoint and distance.